Good morning, students. Today in this video, we are going to cover the poem Rain on the Roof by Coates Kinney. And it is the third poem of the book Beehive. The poem tells us about the poet's sweet memories of his childhood. At night, when dark clouds cover the sky and it rains gently, then the poet lies in his cozy bed and listens to the sound of the raindrops falling overhead on the roof of his cottage. The poet remembers the loving look of his mother, who used to shower love and affection upon her children. So students, from the title of the poem, Rain on the Roof, we can make out that the poem is about the rain. The poet is telling us about the memories he has of the rain and the sound of the raindrops falling on the roof of his house brings back sweet memories of the past. Now let's begin the explanation of the poem Rain on the Roof. When the humid shadows hover over all the starry spheres and the melancholy darkness gently weeps in rainy tears, what a bliss to press the pillow of a cottage chamber bed and lie listening to the patter of the soft rain overhead. Now first we'll get the meaning of the words from the stanza. Humid means full of moisture. Shadows, here the clouds which are laden with moisture and cast shadow on the earth. Hover means move around something, like helicopters or drone. They hover in the sky when they get fixed at one place. Next word is starry spheres. It means night sky, abounding in stars. Melancholy, a feeling of sadness which lasts for a long time. Next word is bliss. It means happiness, blessings. Okay. Next, cottage chamber means poet's bedroom. Patter, it's a sound word, and it means sound of raindrops. Now the explanation of the paragraph. In this stanza, the poet is saying that when the humid shadows hover, here humid shadows refers to dark clouds. Okay, humid shadows means dark clouds which are full of water. The poet is saying that when the sky is full of these clouds, which are moisture laden, are full of water and are about to bring rain, when such clouds hover around in the sky over all the starry spheres refers to the sky at night time when it is full of stars. At that time, huge clouds which are full of moisture move around in the sky, and the sad darkness of the night is wiped off by the raindrops, okay, which seem like tears falling from the sky. The poet is comparing raindrops to tears. Understand? The poet is comparing raindrops to tears, and he says that the dark sky, which seems to be very sad, the dark sky is personified here. And how does it seem? It seemed to be very sad. It appears as if it is crying. Who is crying? The dark sky is crying. And the raindrops are the tears shed by the dark sky. He says that it is a like blessings to lie on the bed in his room, in his cottage chamber means his bedroom, and listen to the sound made by raindrops falling on the roof. Now next stanza. Every tinkle on the shingles has an echo in the heart, and a thousand dreamy fancies into busy being start, and a thousand recollections weave their air threads into woof, as I listen to the patter of the rain upon the roof. Meanings of the words from the stanza. tinkle means short, light, ringing sound. And again, here in this stanza, tinkle is a sound word. It's a sound word. Okay. What does it mean? It means short and light ringing sound. Shingles means rectangular wooden tiles of roof of the house. Tiles of the house. Okay. Echo means reflected sound. Next word is busy being, meaning human beings. And here he refers himself also. He refers himself as busy being. Next word is recollections, means memories of the past. And woof means twist together, weft or intermingle. Patter, again, this is a sound word. Now the explanation of the paragraph. Here the poet is expressing his feelings when he hears the raindrops falling on the roof top of his house. Actually, his house roof is made of tin. Okay, and whenever the rain falls on it, it produces sound. That's why he writes the word patter. He says that every tinkle on the shingles, means tiles of the roof, has an echo in the heart. Whenever he hears rain falling on the rooftop, the sound repeats in his heart and in his dreams. He has many different fanciful imaginations whenever he hears the sound of the raindrop. He says that this sound of the rain falling on the roof top creates many new different dreams in his mind. He recollects, means he remembers many memories of his past which come back into his mind as dreams. So he says that as he listens to the patter of the raindrops upon the roof, he has many new dreams in his mind and the memories of the past come back in the form of dreams. Understand? Now the next and the last paragraph. Now in memory comes my mother, as she used in years agone to regard the darling dreamers, or she left them till the dawn. Oh, I feel her fond look on me as I list to this refrain, which is played upon the shingles by the patter of the rain. Now the words, meaning of the words from the stanza. Agone means bygone or the past, gone by. Okay. Next are means old poetic, it's a, or is old poetic word for before. Then dawn, daybreak, or the time before the sunrise. Next, list. This word is used for listen. Okay, listen, listen. Then refrain, it means a repeated sentence of a song or a poem. Hear the sound made by rain. You might have noticed that a line, sometime repeated in a song again and again, that is called refrain. Which is played upon the shingles. Shingles means again the tiles of the roof, rectangular tiles of the roof, by the patter of the rain. And patter is a sound word. Understand? Now here the poet introduces his mother. He says that he is dreaming of his mother, as he had told in the previous stanza that rain brings memories of the past. It is the memory of his mother who is no longer with him. She is not alive now. In the past, she used to love him or his and his siblings a lot. She used to consider him a darling, and she would let him sleep till daybreak and have sweet dreams. The poet can still feel that his mother is looking at him as he listens to the song made by the raindrops falling on the rooftop of his room. The sound of the rain makes him correlate his past with his present. That is why the poet is moved by the sound of the rain drops on the shingles of his room. Whenever he hears this sound, it brings back memories of the past and he is reminded of his mother. In other words, we can say that these sounds of raindrops arouse thousands of imaginations in the poet's busy mind. The pattering sound of the raindrops also revives a thousand memories of his childhood. One of these memories is related to his dear mother, who is not in this world now. The poet remembers how she used to give a lovely look at her dear children when she put them to sleep and wished them to have sweet dreams before leaving them to meet again the next morning. Okay, while listening to the repetitive rhythms of the raindrops falling on the roof of his cottage, the poet can feel the presence of his mother around him. He visualizes her affectionate look bending over him. Thus, he presents rain as a bridging force between his present and the past. So, that's all about the explanation of the poem, Rain on the Roof. Thank you so much.